I don't know. It's bound to be downstairs. It's bound to be. Yeah. Check, check, check. Okay. Well, we're just about 13 minutes away from the start of today's contest between the UA Costot Colts and the Victoria Pirates, that is. Day two of the Bluebell Ice Cream Classic here at Brenham, Texas. Nice town, really. There's a lot of nice people here. As a matter of fact, got a chance to run into Blinn College, of course, host this particular tournament. And the assistant coach at Blinn College, his wife, and the coach's wives can attest to this. If you're a coach's wife, you wind up doing a lot of stuff in support of your husband. But there are a couple of Arkansas folks from the El Dorado area, as a matter of fact. Got a chance to visit for just a moment with the wife. And they've got a couple of cute little kids that are running around up there helping out. And it's just a real family atmosphere down here at Blinn, Texas. But they wanted to say hi to all their friends back home in Arkansas. As this particular facility, we actually had a chance yesterday. John and I were talking about, well, it's, you know, the Bluebell Ice Cream Classic. Are they going to have any Bluebell ice cream? Well, we wandered through the coach down here at Blinn College. Invited us up to the hospitality room, which was that glassed-in area we showed you on the video last night, and you'll see it again tonight. But again, that is the hospitality room. But would you believe it? It's the Bluebell Ice Cream Classic, and no Bluebell ice cream. We'll be making our recommendations on that because we've been really nice down here. John's been on his best behavior, and I think we may get invited back next year. I'm not sure. I'm sure we will. Anyway, the coach here at Blinn and had a lot of really complimentary things to say about Coach Bird and the program. So last night, of course, if you in case you missed it, it was a tough one last night. UA Costot taking on the host team, Blinn College, and taking on Blinn without the NJCAA Player of the Year last year, at least the District Player of the Year last year, that of course being Terry Anderson. Terry had received a flagrant foul at the end of the ball game the other night. No, he didn't punch anybody or anything like that, but a guy was going in for a dunk, and they ruled it a flagrant foul toward the end of that game, and Terry had to sit this one last night's game out. He's back in the lineup. He's here tonight, but it's just tough to take 28 points out of your lineup and still be competitive, and yet the Colts were led at halftime last night over the host team, which is a Division I NJCAA team, and then wound up on the short end of the scoreboard 76-70. But in talking to Coach Bird after the ball game, he was not disappointed. I mean, you know, nobody really likes moral victories, and I wouldn't call it a moral victory, but what we were wanting to see, can the Colts operate if there's an injury? Can we go with a hole in the lineup? And they came very, very close to knocking off the host team in front of their home fans and everything. It was a good ball game. And this team can compete. And Terry Anderson means a lot to this basketball team, but I think the team proved to themselves that they can compete regardless. And that's big. That'll pay big dividends on down the line because you never know when a star is going to get in foul trouble early or something like that. And that it could very well happen. So anyway, looking forward to what should be a good basketball game today as the Colts get set to take on Victoria College. And we'll be back with more of the pregame show coming up here on ed88radio.com.
Fender bender? Been bumped in the parking lot? Hit a deer? Well, the body shop at Queen Auto Group is known for their quality work. PJ Miner and his crew of certified auto technicians have the equipment and the know-how to get you back on the road good as new. At the body shop at Queen Auto Group, not only do they do the work right, but they take great pride in getting your vehicle in and out of the shop as soon as possible. Cars, pickups, vans, SUVs, you name it, they can fix it. And they work with your insurance company too. So getting your vehicle fixed is a very smooth process. Open weekdays from 8 to 5. It's the body shop at the Queen Auto Group.
This new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar, is it the best Coke ever?
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
Okay, I'm gonna try it first.
Yes!
I need to try it first.
Nice. Do you like my lawn?
Mowed, trimmed, and edged.
To perfection.
Johnson, do you remember what your lawn looked like last year? Because I sure do. And Ron, it might be time to get a new trimmer. But don't worry, guys. I know what you need. Check this out.
Put your hands on professional equipment. Get ready for Husqvarna Days at your local dealer.
Colts basketball on N88 is being brought to you by the good folks at Husqvarna, as well as Coca-Cola, and the folks at the Queen Auto Group, including the Body Shop, which had a chance to look at my Jeep Renegade this past week after it got taken out by an 8-point buck. And yeah, that thing will not be on the road again, but our thanks to the Queen Auto Group and their Body Shop for making that transition as smooth as possible, you bet. Anyway, we're still about 7.5 minutes away from the start of this basketball game. If you're wondering about the opponents tonight, Victoria College, the Pirates, they are. And they're 0-3 on the season. And they took it on the chin last night against Northlake. Northlake will be taking on the host team, Blinn, later on today. But this particular team here, basically you've got Ezra McKee averaging 13.5 points per game. He's a 6'7 freshman forward. And their point guard, Keelan Harkema, he was a 6'2 freshman out of Louisville. Anyway, those are the only two players in double figures. This team averages about, 52 points per game, is that right? Or is it 62 points per game? I got that on a note somewhere here. Anyway, they're averaging 52 points a game, which is about 30 points less than what the Colts are averaging. Now, Victoria College, they've faced some good competition, but, I mean, it's a 30-point spread between what they're scoring and what they're giving up. And, of course, the Colts coming in, whether they're going to have guns fully loaded today because Terry Anderson will be back in that lineup. And there are, I don't know, at least three Colts. If they were on the Victoria team, they would be the team leaders as far as scoring is concerned because, of course, you have Terry Anderson, who is last week's defending NJCAA Player of the Week, National Player of the Week, coming in averaging 28.5 points per game. You got Cameron Woods, averaging like 12 points per game. He had 16 last night. DeCorian Phillips, 15 points per game. He had 13 last night. DeLon Dean in that 76-70 loss to the host team. Well, DeLon wound up with 11 points, but he's averaging 12 points per game. And Shane Bell, who's been coming on as of late, he had 10 points last night. He's getting more and more playing time. He's getting more and more confident in the system. And he's you can just show it shows in the way he's playing. He's enjoying the game a lot more right now as these kids are starting to grow and learn and mesh together. And that's the whole idea between playing some of the competition we're playing right now, because in you look at the big guys in 4-year NCAA basketball, you'll find teams like Arkansas, Kentucky, and folks like Duke. They play a lot of cupcakes. They do. They try to figure out where they are, getting their players to mesh because they brought in a brand new class each and every year. Well, in junior college, you have to understand that probably more than half of your lineup, half of your roster from year in, year out is going to change. And it's important that these guys learn to play together. And Coach Bird believes teaching them how to play together against quality competition. And that's why they're stepping up into Division I. Of course, UA Constantine's a Division II basketball team. But, it's first-class basketball from start to finish as the Colts get set to take on Victoria College. Of course, as we said, Victoria College is a Division I basketball team. Hey, some other things you need to know about UA Constantine basketball. We typically load up in two or three vans, and we head out and we hit the road. Well, this past week, UA Constantine has purchased a bus. Wound up getting a sweet deal on a sweet bus, which is going to – you'll be noticing it around. It'll be like a rolling billboard for the UA Constantine Colts, and that's coming – here in just within a matter of weeks. Hope to have it in time for conference play, and we may have it even sooner. We'll just have to wait and see on that. But you're going to like what you see as this program, Coach Bird, is first class all the way, and you notice it when the kids take the court. Anyway, it's so good to see so many of the family members of these of our basketball team here. A lot of our kids are from the Houston area. That's where, you know, Coach Bird cut his teeth as a basketball coach. And he's got a lot of friends down here. He knows a lot of these kids on both teams because he watched them as they were growing up. He's recruited kids from that we've seen play here for other teams. But we've got some really good kids. A lot of them are from the Houston area. And we're seeing a lot of family members. They've been impressed with what they've seen. Anyway, we're about a couple minutes away from the start of tonight's ball game. We're going to take a quick timeout. Be back with more here on N88Radio.com.
There's a new windshield service in Sevier County. It's Gentry Chevrolet in DeQueen. Yep, you heard right. Gentry Chevrolet is now your one stop for windshield repair and replacement. If they can stop the crack from running, they will. If the windshield needs replacing, they can do that too. Gentry Chevrolet is a full-service Chevrolet dealership with new and used cars and a complete service department, including windshield repair and replacement. Their full inventory is on the Facebook page, on the website GentryChevyInc.com, or at 1027 Highway 70 east of DeQueen.
Don's Easy Pay has been serving families in southwest Arkansas and southeast Oklahoma for over 30 years. Don's Easy Pay is a family-owned business. They carry name brand home furnishings for every room in the house. Living room, dining room, bedroom furniture, name brand kitchen appliances, and electronics too. At Don's Easy Pay, you can rent to own or purchase on the spot with 120 days same as cash. At Don's Easy Pay, you can even rent to own tires. And at Don's Easy Pay, they deliver. Taking time to take care of our customers. It's Don's Easy Pay. This live stream broadcast on Ed88 is made possible by Satellite Service Company in Nashville, your authorized Dish Network dealer. Satellite Service Company and Dish Network serve the entertainment needs of the entire area. You like sports? Dish Network sports packages offer every sports fan exciting action featuring your favorite teams. The Dish Tailgater portable satellite TV antenna lets you watch TV wherever you are, at the lake, in the mountains, or at the tailgate party outside the stadium. The Dish Hopper gives you the power to transform your computer, smartphone, or tablet into your TV and enjoy your home TV anywhere. Special discounts and packages available to fit any budget. Satellite Service Company, 301 South Main Street in Nashville.
Thank you.
you have it. Starting lineups for our basketball teams tonight as we're getting set for NJCAA college, junior college basketball action here on NADARadio.com. Lauren Hinton along with John Bunyard as we get set to go. I try to get situated right here. All right. By Terry Anderson in the jump circle for the Colts. And he'll be facing Chandler Collins Johnson. Young man out of Atascocita High School. As the opening tip is controlled by the Colts. Saved inbounds. Cameron Woods gets it out to Malik Nash. Colts on the attack as we're now underway. Colts work it out on the wing to Terry Anderson. Up top to Bell. Left side to Johnson. Under seat neat to Anderson, that is. His shot will not go in. The rebound. Tipped away, picked up by the Pirates. Victoria College driving through the lane, putting it up and in will be Keelan Harkema. And the Pirates take a 2-0 lead as Anderson fires it in the corner, gets it off to Phillips. Right wing to Malik. And let's see here, we got a carrying is going to be called against the Colts. Good defensive play on the part of Harkema. Tip that basketball away and create the turnover. Inbounds pass will go to Brian McKnight. John was wondering if this is the same Brian McKnight that's a singer, and it's not. Up top with the basketball, Christopher Blair. Blair gets it into the hands of Ezra McKee, their leading scorer. And that pass, nobody home underneath, and the Colts get it back. Trailing 2-0, just underway, just a minute into this basketball game. Colts looking to get back on the winning side after dropping last night's game. Malik Nash up top, gives it left side. Shane Bell fires up the three, can't get it to go. Colts a little cold at the start here. Lob underneath, good defense that time on the part of Shane Bell. Managed to break up that pass. Coming down out of bounds with the basketball was Chandler Collins Johnson. And again, Shane Bell picking up more and more playing time as he's picked up the pace. He's getting more and more comfortable in this system. Malik Nash up top. Works the right side in the corner. Anderson back out front to Shane Bell. Anderson, top of the key. Saw a little bit of room in there. Kicks it right back out. DeCorian Phillips puts it on the way. Will not get it, but there's a good heads-up play on the part of Nash. Malik, so quick. Goes inside the lane. Goes strong to the hole. Lays it up. Can't get it to go. And the Colts will have to get back defensively. Trailing 2-0 with 18 minutes to go here in this first half. Harkema gives it out front to McKnight. Brian working out there against Terry Anderson. McKnight tries to drive down low, and between Anderson and Cameron Woods, are able to tip that ball away. It goes out of bounds. Looks like Malik Nash going to come out of the lineup, and checking in his place will be DeLon Dean. Inbounds pass at way out front into the hands of Christopher Blair. In the corner, Blair puts up the three, no good. Grabbing that rebound to Corian Phillips on the run. Breaks through the lane, lays it up off the glass and good. Phillips breaks the ice for the Colts. So we play 2.5 minutes without him putting any points on the scoreboard, which is, they put a lot of points on the scoreboard. We're tied at 2. Up top, Harkema working against Anderson. Cross court way out front, that pass. A little too high, a little too hard for Ezra McKee. Shane Bell makes the inbounds pass. He'll get it into Phillips. Phillips works it left side to Cameron Woods. Drives inside the lane. Little fall away. Can't get it to go. Got the shot he wanted there. Blair grabs the rebound for the Pirates. Harkema brings it across the midcourt stripe. Fronted out there by DeCorian Phillips. Nice switch that time around the screen. Woods defensively. Harkema fires out left side. Three-pointer on the way. Up and in. Ezra McKee gets his first points of the night. Hits the three And Victoria College takes a 5-2 lead with 16:44 to play in this first half. We got a timeout on the court. We'll take one, too, here on ed88radio.com.
For those living together and those living apart. For classmates, graduates, and teachers making the best of it. For the restaurants delivering to our doorsteps. For the frontline workers putting it on the line every single day. For this great nation determined to be stronger on the other side. Thanks to all of you, we'll be together again.
Here at Blinn College in Brenham, Texas, is DeCorian Phillips facing a little bit of pressure in the backcourt. Gets it ahead to Woods. Cameron lobs it left side. Shane Bell in the corner to Terry Anderson. He'll pull up from three-point land and in and out. No good. The rebound comes off to Harkema. Harkema crosses the midcourt stripe. Needs some help. Good defense out there by DeLon Dean. Up top, Brian McKnight. Out near center court, gets it to Harkema. Colts in their man-to-man, putting some pressure on that basketball. Blair looks down low. He's going to fire it back up top into the hands of point guard McKnight. That shot was partially blocked that time by the Colts. Terry Anderson comes down with it. Gets it ahead to Bell. Bell on the perimeter. Tried to get it back to Anderson. Chasing down that loose ball, DeCorian Phillips. Heads up play that time by Phillips. Phillips at the free throw line to Anderson. Right side, three-pointer on the way and good by DeLon Dean. Dean hits the three and ties it at five. 15:34 to go in this first half. Working on the perimeter. That's Chandler Collins-Johnson. Ball stolen away. That's Shane Bell. Lays it up. The old alley-oop right there. As Bell laid it up there for Anderson, Anderson finishes the play. Give Anderson the basket, and Shane Bell the assist. Colts on top, 7-5. 15:08 to play in this first half. Colts' first lead of the ball game. Three-pointer on the way, won't go, and the rebound's chased down by Collins-Johnson. Right side, that's Harkema, goes inside with it to Blair. Fires it through the lane in the corner. McKnight tries the three, that one will not go. And Anderson grabs that rebound, taking it all the way. Collision out there, and let's see. That's going to be a charging foul on Anderson. I don't think he ever saw the defender right there. He had his eye on a different defender. And that was a full speed collision right there. Coming out of the lineup will be Shane Bell, along with DeCorian Phillips. And it looks like Cortez Collins checking in the lineup for the first time today. So it's Dean. And Malik Nash, DeLon Dean, Malik Nash, Cortez Collins, along with Terry Anderson and Cameron Woods in the lineup. Colts on top, 7-5, 14:42 to play in this first half. Pirates have it on the perimeter. That's McKnight. Let's see. Moving screen going to be called against, that's going to be on Johnny Osby, freshman center out of Akron Garfield High School. Colts have it, facing some full court pressure right here, full court man to man. Then we're going left wing to Anderson, out to Nash, right side it goes to DeLon Dean. Now they work it back to Anderson. Anderson over the screen by the big guy under there. That's Cortez Collins couldn't quite get to that rebound, and they'll bring it the other way. Looks like Jacoria Harris has checked in the lineup for the Colts. Harris defending underneath. And they're going to, he got tangled up. The 223's got tangled up right there. Harris is going to get called for the personal foul, I'm sure. As Johnny Osby is going to be going to the free throw line. Osby shots on the way, and it's good. Osby gets his first point of the night. Second shot on the way, off front of the iron, no good. And Cortez Collins grabs that rebound. Colts still on top, 7-6. Just under 14 minutes to play in the first half. Bounce pass right side. DeLon Dean back out front to Nash. Collision out front. Both players going for the ball, so no call. Anderson gets it back out to Nash. Right side to DeLon Dean. Long three. Nails it. DeLon Dean with his second long-range three-pointer tonight. He's got six. Colts have their biggest lead of the night at 10-6. 13:35 to go in this first half. Brian McKnight gives it off to Blair. Christopher Blair is going to be called for a travel, and the Colts get it right back. No, that's actually a foul here. I'm sorry. Personal foul is going to be Johnny Osby. That's his second personal foul. Actually, they gave that to Blair, so that's actually on Blair. Christopher Blair called for the personal foul. Colts have it. They'll work it left side. Dean takes the three. He's been hot. That one will not go. Jacoya Harris gets the rebound underneath. He's going to be fouled in the act of shooting. Jacoya out of Little Rock. Says one of the cool things he likes to do in the country is go mudding. Shots on the way off the back of the iron, no good. He'll have another one coming. Your Colts on top, 10-6. 13-16 to go in this first half. That's true. Second shot by Jacoria. That one would not go. And the rebound fought for going to be pulled down by Ezra McKee. Here come the Pirates, trailing 10-6, 13:05 to play in this first half. As Brian McKnight looking for some help. Oh, I think he traveled inside that lane. No call right there. And now they're going to call DeLon Dean for the reach. So DeLon Dean called for the personal. That's his first, by the way. And that is the, they say that's the third team foul against the Colts. Bounce pass underneath. Dean there putting the pressure on. Rebound pulled down by Cortez Collins. Gets it ahead to Terry Anderson. Anderson right side to Malik Nash. Nash gives it back to Jacoria Harris through the lane, up and in. In traffic, nice body control, was able to get that shot up off the glass and good. And the personal foul is going to be on Johnny Osby. That'll be his second. And heading to the free throw line will be Jacoria Harris to try to finish off the old-fashioned three-point play. Harris gets his first two of the night. Shots on the way. That one's off the iron, no good. He's 0 for 3 at the charity stripe so far. And the Colts on top by a half a dozen, though, 12-6. 12 and a half minutes to go in this first half. Colts not exactly setting the world on fire offensively, but doing a good job on the defensive end. Three-pointer on the way. Won't go. That one by McKee, who is their top scorer. McKee with 3 points here in the early going. And the Colts have it. Terry Anderson up top. Works it left side. DeCorian Phillips, a little fall away right there. In and out, no good. And the rebound is going to be tipped out of bounds. Last touched by the Pirates. I think the Pirate defender right there, Noah Layton, thought that ball was actually last touched by the Colts and didn't. He just let it go out of bounds. The Colts will have it back after this timeout. 11:58 to play in the first half. Our score, Casa tie 12, Victoria 6. Back in a moment on ed88radio.com.
At Diana's Clothing and Gifts on Collinery Drive in DeQueen, shop a fantastic selection of women's fashion apparel. Keep your style fresh with the latest trendy tops, jeans, and dresses, plus lots of new arrivals. Let Diana's help you with your home decorating needs. Make your home even more personal with our assortment of home decor and decorative accessories. And discover our collection of gifts for that special person in your life. There are gifts for every occasion. It's a great family-owned business. People come from all over to visit Diana's. Stay updated with new stuff on their Facebook page. Located at 804 West Collinery Drive in DeQueen, Diana's Clothing and Gifts, 870-642-6528.
fires it out in the corner. Terry Anderson puts up the three, knocks it down. And the Colts lead by nine as Anderson with 5 points in the ballgame. Colts have hit three threes thus far. 9 of their 15 points from beyond the arc. Shot put up, hard off the glass, and then off the hands of Cortez Collins. Rebound picked up, tossed up and in by Johnny Osby. Osby now, 3 points in the ballgame. Colts lead it 15-8. Left side, Cameron Woods gets it over to DeCorian Phillips, and a reaching call going to be on number 15. That'll be Noah Latin. Latin called for the personal foul. That's his first. Like Cortez Collins coming out of the lineup. And checking back in will be Shane Bell. So it's Anderson along with Phillips and Woods, Jacoria Harris, and Shane Bell in the lineup for the Colts. Anderson gets it in the corner, driving the baseline. That's Shane Bell. Gets in some traffic, fires it back out to Corian Phillips. They'll get it in the corner now to Terry Anderson. 11 seconds on the shot clock. Penetrates, gets it off to Jacoria Harris, and Harris puts it up and in. Harris gets the basket, another assist for Anderson. And the Colts back on top by 9, 17-8. They'll put a little pressure on in the backcourt here. And good backside defense that time by Shane Bell, racing in there to tip the ball out of bounds. So the Pirates will have it on the baseline, trailing 17-8 with 10:40 to play in this first half. Ezra McKee to make the inbounds pass. Gets it into Osby. Osby shot up and in. Colts lead by 7, 17-10. Cameron Woods made that look easy. Cameron just drove it inside the lane, picked up a little pressure, popped the little 7-foot jumper as a shot partially blocked that time by Jacoria Harris. Gets it ahead to Shane Bell, or actually that was Cameron Woods. Left side to Bell in the corner. There's Anderson from that spot. He found his spot out there. Anderson with a couple of threes. He's got 8, and the Colts are on top by 12 now, 22-10. 10 minutes to go in this first half. And let's see. Look like Colts, DeCorian Phillips may have taken one right there off the nose. A little injury timeout on the court right now, so we'll go ahead and take a timeout as well. Our score: Colts 22, Victoria 10. Back in a moment on Ed88Radio.com.
When you order a quarter pounder with cheese, you're committing your uninterrupted attention to a quarter pound of fresh beef. It's the world's best tasting do not disturb sign. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Colts basketball. Did he get a scratch on his nose, John?
Scratched or hit in the nose right there. Something's bleeding. They're looking at it.
Yeah, they came out of the ball game to get some attention to that. But on the court right now, looks like we're going to see Jordan Wright for the first time tonight out there with Jacoria Harris, along with Shane Bell, Terry Anderson, and Cameron Woods. Bell gets it to Woods. Woods looking. Gets it in the corner to Anderson. He's hit two of them out there. Is that one going to count? Nope. He nailed it out there. He's found his spot, but a turnover on the part of the Colts. I didn't see what the call was. There was no foul called.
Out of bounds or something?
Possibly. I did not see what they called right there. Osby with it up top. Gets it over to McKee. Almost lost it off his foot right there. Anderson putting the pressure on. Lob pass in the corner. Getting back defensively was Bell. That one is going to be off the foot of Kai Blodgett out of Katy, Texas. Colts with it now. Up top, Shane Bell. Colts on top by 12, 22-10. Cameron Woods directing traffic out there. Gets it out to Shane Bell. Bell's going to back it out a little bit. Fires it in the corner to Anderson. He likes that left corner. He's in the right corner this time. Shot on the way by Jordan Wright will not go, but there's Anderson to grab that rebound, put it right back up and in. Anderson now in double figures, making up for that lost game he had yesterday. Colts on top by 14, their biggest lead of the night. 8:40 to go in this first half. Ball almost stolen away, and Woods still going for it right there, and I think my Cameron Woods going to be called for the personal foul. A lot of extra effort on the part of Cameron Woods. He's going to come out for just a moment. Looks like Luke Bright is going to check in his place. McKee with it in the lane. Put a little shove on Anderson there. There's Luke Bright with another big rebound. He had a big one last night toward the end of that ball game. Gave the Colts a second chance basket right there. This time, right place, right time. Good position. Gets the rebound. Gets it ahead. Left side on the perimeter. That's Bright. Deep in the corner to Anderson. Anderson fires it underneath. Back out in the corner. Shane Bell, long three. Can't get it to go. The rebound underneath. Jordan Wright had it momentarily. Let's see. Apparently it went out of bounds off of Bell. Shane had the spot. Jordan Wright had the spot he wanted underneath for that rebound. Just couldn't quite come up with it. McKee thought about the shot, battling in there. Boy, the Colts doing a good job on him. Kind of slung it up there with one hand, hoping to get the tip in. But instead, there's Ja'Coria Harris to grab that rebound. Gets it ahead to Shane Bell. Bell on the attack. Lost it off his leg momentarily. Picks it back up. Working out there as Luke Bright grabs that pass. Gets it over to Terry Anderson. Anderson with it. Fires it left side. Shane Bell the three. Can't get it to go. And the rebound. And let's see. Okay, apparently the Victoria player, the Pirate, was standing on the line down there when he grabbed that rebound. Looks like Ja'Coria Harris going to come out. And Malik Nash back in the lineup. Nash, Bell, Bright, along with Jordan Wright and Terry Anderson in the lineup for the Colts. Right side, that's Bright, deep in the corner. Back up on the wing to Malik. Nash gets it right side now. Driving through the lane, scooping it up and in. That's Shane Bell. Bell gets his first two of the night. It's like the Red Sea opened, and he just wandered in. 26-10. Colts on top by 16 right now. As McKnight slings it up toward the basket. Good tip in that time by Osby. Johnny Osby. And on the other end, let's see. And there's going to be a blocking foul going to be called on Noah Latin. Latin's called for his second personal foul of the night. Actually, it's his third. And Malik Nash will head to the free throw line. Seventh team foul against the Pirates. Nash takes his time, sends it on the way, and up and in. That's the first free throw the Colts have made today. They were 0 for 3 prior to that. Nash with his first point of the night. And coming out of the lineup will be Jordan Wright. And checking back in will be Ja'Corian Phillips. So it's Phillips, Nash, Anderson, Bell, and Bright in the lineup for the Colts. They lead it 27-12, 6:43 to play in this first half. Malik, second shot on the way, and good. It's kind of snuggled into that net right there. And the Colts on top by 16, 28-12, equaling their biggest lead of the night. Keelan Harkema with the basketball, gets to cross the midcourt stripe into the hands of Kenvontis Turner. Turner goes high, off the glass, no good, and the rebound comes off to Corian Phillips. He get it ahead to Nash. Colts looking for numbers here. Lob pass underneath, had Terry Anderson streaking for the basket, just a little bit too tall. Anderson couldn't quite control the pass. They were going for the alley-oop that time. Looks like Luke Bright's going to get a breather right now, and coming back in will be DeLon Dean. Bell, Anderson, Dean, and Nash in the lineup for the Colts. Colts steal the ball away. They'll work it left side in the corner. Three-pointer on the way by Anderson. Will not go this time. And the rebound comes off to McKee. Ezra's pass down court, tipped out of bounds. A good defense that time on the part of DeLon Dean. And the Pirates will turn it over with the Colts on top, 28-12. 6:10 to go in this first half. Hope everyone's having a good Saturday. Glad you're joining us here on at88radio.com. Colts taking part in the Bluebell Ice Cream Classic, Blinn College in Brenham, Texas. In the corner, three-pointer on the way by Shane Bell. Up and in. Colts hitting from the perimeter tonight. They've got five threes in this first half. Perimeter shooting has been a problem for the Colts. Loose ball on the court, picked up by Anderson. Went up strong to the basket, goes down. And he is going to be fouled in the act of shooting by Ezra McKee. McKee called for his first. Anderson heading to the free throw line. Terry, 10 points in the ball game. 5:40 to play in this first half. Colts on top by 19, 31-12. Anderson shot on the way, good. Make it a 20-point lead right now for the Colts. Looks like a leading scorer for the Pirates. Ezra McKee is going to come out of the lineup right now. As Anderson gets set for his second shot. Free throws in and out, no good. And that rebound is going to be pulled down by Kenyatta's Turner out of Corpus Christi High School. On the other end, shot put up. Oh, nice hesitation. Laid it off the glass. Tried to draw the foul, but Collins Johnson puts it up and in. Three-pointer on the way by DeLon Dean is in there. DeLon Dean has three threes on the night. That's good to see. You knew he's capable of that. It's really hard to get in the rhythm here in the early part of the season. As Dean steals it away, goes all the way, jams it home. Long range, short range, he's doing it all tonight. He's got 11. Colts get back defensively. Lob pass underneath. Shot put up by Blair is up and in. Blair gets the basket. That's his first two. And the Colts fire it through the lane. DeLon Dean lays it up and in. Nice pass that time by Anderson. Dean with 13 now leads the Colts in scoring. And we've got a timeout on the court. 4:41 to play in this first half. It's Colts 39, Victoria 16. Back in a moment on at88radio.com.
Salinas Satellite Service in DeQueen is a corporate partner of Ed88. Salinas is a Southwest Arkansas Dish Network provider offering all the latest package deals. And if you should encounter a problem, Salinas' experienced service technicians are just a phone call away. The very latest in Dish Network home entertainment equipment can be found.
Kind of scared ourselves for just a moment there. As today's broadcast being brought to you in part by Salinas Satellite Service in DeQueen.
Nothing compared to last night. I wasn't scared a bit. It was doing a lot funnier things last night than it's been doing now.
When we see DeLon Dean out on the court, the one thing he took command of everybody coming off the bus. They carried all of our equipment in today. But he told us in exchange for that, you got to get the stream on time tonight. We assured him it wasn't us. I'm not sure he bought it, though.
I think we're going to have to throw out one of our pieces of equipment.
Maybe one of our equipment operators, too. I don't know. Anyway, Colts back defensively. Pass underneath. Shot put up and rejected by Terry Anderson. 39-16. Colts on top by 23 with 4.5 minutes to play in this first half. Hard to get that ball in, and he couldn't. Good defense by DeLon Dean. Dean's turned it up a notch today. He's got, like we say, he's got, 13 points in the ball game? Is that right? It is 13 points, including three threes. Made some good defensive plays as well. Malik Nash will bring it across, the Pirate at midcourt. Actually, it's a Buccaneer at midcourt. We're playing the Pirates today. Left side. That's Dean. Bounce pass to Nash. Nash in the corner. Three-pointer on the way by DeCorian Phillips. DeCorian hits his first three of the night. Make it seven threes. 21 of the Colts' 42 points have come from outside the arc. Half of their point production thus far. Kenyatta's Turner with the basketball up front. Working against Dean. Gets a little bit of room underneath. Could not finish, however. And the rebound comes off to Dean. Fires it ahead to Anderson. Anderson in that open court. Collision underneath. No call. Anderson lays it off the glass and good. Pretty move on the part of Terry Anderson. Colts lead it 44-16. Shot inside the arc. Put up. No good. Rebound. Tipped around. Fought for. Picked up by Victoria College. Just heads up hard work right there. Blue collar basket by Kenyatta's Turner. Anderson kicks it in the corner. Three-pointer on the way up and in. Cameron Woods.
Lining up like a Christmas tree.
Yes, they are. Woods with his first three of the day.
It's like in baseball, they start hitting and
everybody's knocking it down. 49-18.
You could go out there and probably hit a couple.
I'd take that bet in a heartbeat. Three-pointer on the way off, no good. The rebound comes off to Malik Nash. Nash with that head up, fires it ahead to Anderson. Anderson into the lane, kicks it back out. Three-pointer on the way by Dean, won't go. Rebound is going to be chased down by Kenyatta's Turner. And let's see, looks like Woods may be called for a reach that time. So Cameron's picked up his second personal foul. That's only the fifth team foul against the Colts. In the last couple of games, John, we were on the short end of that foul situation. Seemed like every time. Tonight, we've had five personal team fouls, and Victoria's had eight. Three-pointer on the way won't go. Good block out that time by Woods, but sticking with the play and causing the ball to be turned over is Kenyatta's Turner. Managed to knock it back off the Colts. And the Buccaneers will put the ball in play underneath their own basket as Cameron Woods is going to get a break right here, and checking in his place will be Leighton Jackson. Jackson gets out there on the ball. Blair with it, and the ball goes out of bounds off the fingertips of Turner. Colts get it back on top, 47-18. 2:13 to play in this first half. Left side, three-pointer on the way by Dean is good. DeLon Dean with his fourth three-pointer of the night. 16 points in the ball game. Ball stolen away by Anderson. Anderson in the open court. Kicks it left side. Three-pointer on the way by DeCorian Phillips is good. It's raining out there. Raining threes. DeCorian hits his second three of the night. He's got 8 points. 53-18 with a minute 30 to go in this first half. Three-pointer on the way by Turner's no good. There's Anderson to grab the rebound. Colts will run it the other way. Ahead to Dean. Oh, DeLon, collision right there. And that's going to be a charging foul on DeLon Dean. And the tie thing there, the pass was in a place right there. He had a hard time handling it. And in order to control it, to his credit, he was able to get it forward to a teammate, but had no choice. Being off balance, ran over the defender. Coach Bird giving him a hard time right now. DeLon has really stepped up his game today. Makes a lot of difference when you start hitting those threes like that. You can see the confidence coming back. As the ball is tipped away, stolen away by Terry Anderson. Goes all the way, slams it home over the top, and a technical foul on Terry Anderson. As he went strong to the basket, had a man underneath him, might have said something to him on the way down. And the official right there called the technical foul. So Anderson picks up the personal foul, gets the basket, and we'll head to the other end to shoot a technical foul here. And it looks like the Colts want a timeout right now to talk that one over. So we're going to take a timeout as well with a minute 7 to play in this first half. UAC 55, Victoria College 18. Back in a moment on ed88radio.com.
When you order a quarter pounder with cheese, you're committing your uninterrupted attention to a quarter pound of fresh beef. It's the world's best tasting, do not disturb sign. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Colts have a comfortable 55-18 lead heading to the free throw line. Will be Keelan Harkema. Harkema shooting the technical foul opportunity. That's his third point of the ball game. They're two leading scorers. The only two players on this team in double figures on an average night are Harkema and McKee. And thus far in this first half, they have combined 4 7 points as Harkema hits that second free throw. He's got 4 points. McKee has three. And the Colts lead at 55-20. As McKee will get it in to Harkema. And the Pirates will bring it into the front court. Chandler Collins Johnson. Kid has three last names here. As the shot's put up inside the lane. No good. The rebound comes off to DeCorian Phillips. Phillips will run it into the front court. Goes right side into the lineup. That's DeCoria Harris. Lost the handle on the basketball momentarily as the Buccaneers pull up. Leighton Jackson grabs that rebound, gets it to Harris. He gives it on to DeCorian Phillips. Phillips spinning, gets it right side to Nash in the corner. DeLon Dean for three. DeLon is on fire. He's got 5 3-pointers in this first half, 19 points, and the Colts with 10 seconds to go in the first half, lead at 58-20. McKee works it over on the left wing to Chandler Collins Johnson. Back out to Blair. He'll get it to Harkema. Tries to draw the double team. Shot on the way at the buzzer. No good. And we've come to the end of the first half of play. Our score, it's the Colts, 58. Victoria, 20. We're back in a moment on ed88radio.com.
Salinas Satellite Service in DeQueen is a corporate partner of Ed 88. Salinas is a Southwest Arkansas Dish Network provider offering all the latest package deals. And if you should encounter a problem, Salinas experienced service technicians are just a phone call away. The very latest in Dish Network home entertainment equipment can be found at Salinas Satellite in downtown DeQueen.
Halftime here at Blinn Community College, Brenham, Texas, home of the Bluebell Ice Cream Classic, in which the UACostat Colts lead the Pirates of Victoria College by a score of 58-20. Yeah, that's right, 58-20. Colts, the big difference in this ball game has been the fact they've been raining down some threes. DeLon Dean has three threes. Two threes for Terry Anderson, two threes for DeCorian Phillips. Also hitting a three, Shane Bell. Cameron Woods has a three-pointer as well. So the Colts really hitting from the perimeter. 19 points in the ballgame for DeLon Dean. 15 points for Terry Anderson. Looks like 8 points for DeCorian Phillips. 5 points each for Shane Bell and Cameron Woods. 4 points for Jacoria Harris. 2 points for Malik Nash. Meanwhile, the Pirates tonight are led in scoring by Johnny Osby. He's got 7 points in that first half. Looks like 4 points in the ball game for Keelan Harkema. 3 points for Ezra McKee. 2 points each for Keatis Turner and Christopher Blair. And again, our score at the half, it's the Colts 58 and the Pirates 20. And we'll be back with more on the halftime here on ed88radio.com.
When you order a quarter pounder with cheese, you're committing your uninterrupted attention to a quarter pound of fresh beef. It's the world's best tasting do not disturb sign. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Sevier County Farmers Co-op in DeQueen has cattle panels, fencing, water troughs, feed bins, culverts, you name it. At the feed store, find cattle feed, horse feed, goat, swine, rabbit, and pet feeds. The co-op is the area's Purina dealer. The staff on hand has built a reputation through the years of having what farmers and ranchers need when they need it. It's all at the co-op. They even have deer feed to help you draw in that big buck. At the co-op service station, they'll fix you up with car and truck tires, tractor tires. They fix flats and do oil changes. Plus, they're a full service station. Neighbors working with neighbors to make our corner of the world a better place. It's the Sevier County Farmers Co-op.
We're going to take a quick time out right now. There's a big event coming up in DeQueen tonight. It's a benefit for area veterans. Of course, this past Thursday was Veterans Day. And one of our community leaders, that would be the folks at Healthcare Express. And I tell you what, Christy and Hector Gallegos there have done such a good job. Brand new members of our community have been very much involved in a lot of different things, including our veterans, American Legion, post number 54, but very much involved in the community. And one of the things they're sponsoring this weekend is a street dance tonight in downtown DeQueen, and one of the things associated with that is a food drive for our area veterans. And one of our good friends, Sandy Brewster, of Hale Real Estate Sales, was in our studio earlier this week to talk about that food drive and to talk about that particular event tonight. And we've got street dance with Sandy Brewster coming up here on Ed88Radio.com.
And it is time now for our fun fact of the day, Friday edition, brought to you this morning by Don's Easy Pay. And in our studio today, somebody we haven't seen in a long time. Yeah. It's Sandy Brewster. That is Mrs. Smokin' Dave right there. Yeah, buddy. Do they ever call you that, Mrs. Smokin' Dave?
A few have,
or do they just call him Mr. Sandy?
Well, it kind of goes both ways.
Of course, Sandy is with Hale Real Estate Sales, and who, by the way, bring us the local reminders each and every morning here on Ed88Radio.com. And anyway, Sandy, we've got something special coming up this Saturday, downtown DeQueen.
Yes, sir.
I can't recall the last time we had a street dance downtown.
It's been a while. With the COVID and everything, I'm sure that's
why
it's been a while.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, and even before that, I mean, once upon a time, towns had street dances. It was fun, just a good time to get together. You know, sometimes we don't do as much of that anymore. And I think it's great. We're going to get together. What time?
It's going to start at 5 p.m. Saturday evening end at 10.
Okay. And I'm guessing this is going to be on what? Queen Avenue, right?
Yeah, I'm assuming the Courthouse Square,
And anyway, we're going to have some music, and we're just going to have some vendors, and we're going to have just a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, it's going to be a great time. Everybody ought to come out and check it out.
Now, what you're involved in is going to be something that's really good for the community.
Yes, we're helping Healthcare Express gather non-perishable food items for the American Legion, which, of course, is for the veterans.
Right, right.
And so for every non-perishable food item you bring, you get a chance to enter your name in a drawing for $100 cash that'll be given away that night.
Fantastic.
And then we got a few for people who don't bring stuff. We also have places they can sign up to win gift certificates to some of the local businesses here in town.
And I'm guessing if a person forgot to bring canned goods, y'all would accept cash. I mean, we just go ahead and put that in the kitty as well.
Well, sure, yeah. Cash is always good. It works well.
Absolutely.
Or a check, a money order.
Anything we can do. You know.
Yeah, just not debit cards because I don't have the slider thing on my phone. Yeah.
Well, you know, just yesterday we wrapped up here on the campus of UA Cossetot in DeQueen. We wrapped our Veterans Day breakfast up.
Yes.
And as a matter of fact, I saw Hector from Healthcare Express. He was here. He's a proud member of American Legion post number 54, but there is a need in our for those that have served their country, and And, you know, there's some folks that struggle from meal to meal. And
there
this is a big deal.
It is a big deal. And you know, without the veterans, we wouldn't be where we were today.
Absolutely.
You know, so let's try to give back. And let's all go have a good time, listen to some music, see some old friends, maybe gossip a little bit, you know. And just enjoy each other's company.
Absolutely.
And also for a good cause, for the veterans.
So if maybe there's somebody out there going, you know, well, I kind of like to help out. I mean, I'd like to give and everything, but maybe we need some volunteers. Maybe somebody else has an idea to help out with the
veterans.
Well, sure. How would we go about, who do we need to call?
The Healthcare Express.
Okay.
Is what, they're the ones sponsoring this.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just kind of wanted to help out a little bit and do our part at Hale Real Estate. But they are the ones that you would need to call if you wanted to set up something.
And that number is?
That number is 870-518-0028.
All right. Well, Sandy, I appreciate it so much. Keep up the good work. It's a wonderful thing you're helping out with right here. And we certainly, we do appreciate our veterans, and we appreciate those that want to serve our veterans. That's awesome.
Yeah, it is. And I appreciate your time getting all this out for everybody so they'll know what's going on.
All right. See y'all at the street dance. All right.
All righty. Thank you.
And she is Sandy. And that is our fun fact of the day, brought to you this morning by Don's Easy Pay here on Ed 88.
Scared ourselves for just a moment right there, but looks like we're back again. I was just going to tell DeLon Dean after the ball game today, hey, you know how you told us make sure you get that stream on and start the ball game? Well, you're going to tell us that every time because it seemed to work today, and then running into some streaming problems again today, but hey, no big deal. It makes a whole lot of difference when you're up by a score of 58 to 20 as opposed to not knowing where you're at in the ball game, right? Anyway, we're going to pause right now, take a quick timeout, be back with more right after this on ed88radio.com. All right, well, we may just keep it right here instead. That'd be fine. We're good. Rather than take a chance at losing it, we'll just keep it right here. By the way, Colts basketball on ed88radio.com is being brought to you today by Husqvarna, by our good friends at Tyson Foods, also by the folks at Coca-Cola, and by McDonald's. Colts lead it 58-20, and the perimeter shooting here in this first half has been a big, big difference for the Colts. As a matter of fact, they had 9, 10, 11 three-pointers.
made in that first half. So 33 of their 58 points have come from beyond the arc. And of those, five of those 11 threes off the fingertips of DeLon Dean. Meanwhile, Terry Anderson has a couple of threes. DeCorian Phillips has a pair of threes, a three-point shot for Shane Bell, and one for Cameron Woods. And again, the Colts lead it at the intermission by a score of 58-20. We're only about 2.5 minutes away from the start of the second half. Now, the Colts and Lady Colts both going to be getting a little bit of a break. Won't be playing again until Thursday of this week. And then we're going to be playing Thursday and Friday. Now, on Thursday, it'll be the men's and women's teams from Southern University Shreveport coming up to Locksburg, to the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gymnasium. It's a 5 o'clock tip-off for the ladies. The men play at 7. And then on Friday night, and we don't play very many Friday night games, but we're going to be getting on the bus. We're going up to Crowley's Ridge College that we'll be taking on their junior varsity teams up there. And remember Brad Phillips? He was a coach here at UA Costa a couple of years ago. He is the ladies' coach at Crowley's Ridge. And so we'll be at Crowley's Ridge on Friday night for a pair of men's and women's games. Again, 5 o'clock tip-off. And you'll catch all the action all season long on ed88radio.com as the two teams gather around their coaches. And we're almost set to get underway with second half action here. As the Colts, they're ready to get on that court and get going here. It's a long road trip down to Brenham, Texas from DeQueen, Arkansas. It took us about, it felt like 8 hours yesterday. We were on the road a long, long time. Got in some traffic and construction. It was a tough trip. Anticipating things will go a lot quicker this time on the way home, but probably going to be rolling into town 10, 11 o'clock, something like that tonight.
We stopped tonight too, though.
So oh, yeah, several times. I mean, the kids are well fed. I'll put it that way. Anyway, Terry Anderson, along with DeCorian Phillips, Malik Nash, Shane Bell, and also Cameron Woods. Cameron Woods in the lineup for the Colts. As the Pirates will inbound the ball to start the second half. It'll be Ezra McKee to make the inbounds pass. Looks like we're set to go. Got 20 minutes on the clock. Everybody ready here? I think we are. Inbounds pass goes to Harkema. And the Pirates have the basketball to start this second half. In the corner, that's Brian McKnight. Spins. Gets it back out to Chandler Collins Johnson. Over to Harkema. Right side to McKnight. Back to Harkema. Tries to go down low, and Shane Bell's going to be called for using the body right there. Bumped him a time or two. Got by with the first bump, but not the second one. And that's a personal foul against Bell. I believe that's his first. As McKee will trigger the inbounds pass. Tries to go right left side to Harkema. His shot no good, but Blair's there for the rebound. Couldn't get the tip to go. Gets his own rebound, puts it back up and in. A little blue collar work there on the part of Christopher Blair. He's got 4 points. And the Colts lead cut back to 36 at 58-22. Malik Nash gets it to DeCorian Phillips. Phillips to Terry Anderson. Almost, he managed to get that foot down in time. Three-pointer up and in by Shane Bell. Bell, 8 points in the ball game. That's 12 three-pointers in this game for the Colts. That's McKee on the perimeter. Ezra looks inside, bounce pass down low to Blair. Tried to get it back to McKee. That's going to go off the ankles of Terry Anderson. 61-22, Colts on top, 39-point margin here with 18:46 to play in the ball game. Oh, nice lane to the basket, lays it up and in, and he's going to be called for the travel, yeah. That looked like Chandler Collins Johnson found him a way to get an easy basket right there, but called for the travel, and the Colts get it back. After the turnover, Cameron Woods gets it out to Anderson, left side to Nash, deep in the corner. That's Shane Bell attacking, fires it out to Anderson, goes right side to DeCorian Phillips in the corner to Cameron Woods.
12 seconds on the shot clock. Top of the key to DeCorian Phillips. That one will not go, and the rebound pulled down by Chandler, excuse me, by Ezra McKee. That's one of the few threes that's went up tonight that hadn't went in for the Colts. They have been wearing out the arc tonight. Brian McKnight with the ball, gets it to Ezra McKee. McKee around the screen by Blair, gets it over to Harkema, drives through the lane, shot is blocked by Anderson. Anderson in the open court. Nice dish underneath the Bell. Shane, reverse layup, lays it up and in with the left hand. Nice basket that time. Give Anderson the assist, and Shane Bell in double figures with 10. And as of late, you can count on him for 10 points every night. He's pretty consistent. Backing it out, throwing up the three will be McKee. And let's see, the rebound underneath by Blair, but Blair may have taken an inadvertent shot to the eye that time. And the personal foul is going to be on Malik Nash. Nash called for the personal. And I think Blair is going to be going to the free throw line. Blair is listed as a 6'10", at 6'10", on the roster here. He does. He is a wide body. He's got some shoulders on him. Lob pass inside goes to Blair. Right side. Backing it out to McKee. Lobs it into Blair. Blair has it tipped away by Nash. Malik gets it ahead to DeCorian Phillips. He'll go all the way, lay it up and in. DeCorian Phillips in double figures with 10. And the Colts lead it 65-22 with 17:05 to go in the ball game. Up top, that's Harkema, gets it down to Blair. Blair dishes over to Brian McKnight at the free throw line. Lost it momentarily. Goes down low as McKee has it stripped away. Blair picks it up, hesitates, lays it up on the backside, won't go, and Anderson grabs a rebound. Terry gets it ahead to Malik Nash. Nash on the arc, gets it out to DeCorian Phillips. Working against the big guy, Blair, gets it over to Cameron Woods, back over to DeCorian Phillips. Phillips lobs it inside to Anderson, deep in the corner. Bell with the three-pointer won't go. Anderson had the rebound momentarily, picked up by Bell, gets it over to DeCorian Phillips. DeCorian's shot on the drive will not go, and the rebound's going to be hauled down by Brian McKnight. Ahead to Harkema, left side it goes. Three-pointer on the way, rattles around and goes down. So Ezra McKee now has 6 points in the ballgame. Leading scorer for the Pirates, averaging 13.5 points per game. He's got 6 tonight. Three-pointer on the way by Shane Bell will not go, and that rebound's going to be pulled down by Harkema. Harkema breaks the midcourt stripe. That's Cameron Woods out there putting the pressure on that basketball. Lob pass underneath. Stripped away, coming out of there with it is DeCorian Phillips. Yeah, it looked like the Pirates going to have an easy basket right there, but Phillips, somebody forgot to tell Phillips. He grabs that ball. They bring it the other way, laying it off the glass and good. That's Cameron Woods. Woods with a basket. He's got 7. And the Colts lead it 67-24. 15:15 to go in the contest. McKee on the perimeter, gets it left side, going down low. Shot is blocked out of the air by Cameron Woods. Ahead to Anderson. Anderson on the attack, nice spin, kicks it in the corner. That's going to be Cameron Woods for 3. That one's in and out, no good, and the rebound's going to be pulled down by the Pirates. On the other end, shot put up and in. And the Colts lead at 67-27. Meanwhile, Bell draws the double team, gets it on the perimeter. Anderson will take the 3. That one will not go. Harkema grabs the rebound. Here come the Pirates. Nice pass in traffic that time. And rattling around and knocking it down will be Jalen Singletary. Singletary out of Akron, Ohio, gets the basket. And the Colts' lead is cut back to 38. Malik Nash in the corner gets it to DeCorian Phillips. That one will not go. The Colts having some trouble from the perimeter right now. Anderson has it. They'll work it down low. Into the hands of Cameron Woods. Draws the contact. Couldn't get the shot to go, but he's going to the free throw line to shoot a pair. Cameron Woods has the
free throw line, and personal foul is going to be on Jalen Singletary. So Cameron Woods at the free throw line. He's got 7 points in the ball game. Make it 8 as that one's up and in. That's his first free throw attempt of the night. Colts, by the way, have only shot 6 free throws, 7/8 free throws on the night. They're 4 out of 8 at the charity stripe. So Cameron will have another one here with 14:07 to play in the ball game. Colts on top, 68-29. And that second shot, no good. Cortez Collins in the lineup. Rebounds goes out of bounds off his fingertips. So Cameron Woods is going to come out of the lineup, checking in his place. Will be Jacoria Harris. Harris, DeLon Dean, Cortez Collins, Terry Anderson, and Malik Nash in the lineup for the Colts. On the perimeter, that's Jalen Singletary. Singletary will get it out to Osby. And the ball stolen away. Here come the Colts. Anderson slings it in the corner. Three-pointer on the way by DeLon Dean. He has been on fire today. That is his 6th three-pointer of the night. He's got 22 points in the ball game. Putting the pressure on Harkema up top. Gets it off to Brian McKnight. McKnight, step back 3. Won't go. Rebound. There's Cortez Collins, the big kid out of Vivian, Louisiana, grabs a rebound. He gets it ahead to Malik Nash. Nash, spin move up top, drives through the lane, scoops it up, can't get it to go. Stretches out on the court, but he'll be going to the free throw line as he is fouled by Johnny Osby. That should be the 3rd on Osby, I think. Yes, it is. For those of you that are Harlem Globetrotters fans, he spells his name differently than Goose Osby. Or was it Geese Osby? At the free throw line, Malik Nash puts it up and in. Nash, 3 points in the ballgame, all of them from the free throw line today. Malik, point guard for the Colts, the engine that makes it go. Second shot, up and in. Nash with 4 points. And the Colts lead it 73-29. In the lineup right now for the first time tonight, Larrion Ford. That's Jalen Singletary, fires it up top to Osby. Right side it goes to McKee. McKee working against Anderson. And they get over to Harkema. He's working against Malik Nash. Colts. Defensively, 4 seconds on the shot clock will not go, and the rebound is tipped around by Malik Nash, picked up by Anderson in the open court. Brings it down court, gets it, free throw line. Cortez Collins, his shot won't go at the free throw line, and the rebound comes off to the Pirates. Victoria College into the front court. Larrion Ford will back it out. Stands near the midcourt stripe, bounce pass right side to Jalen Singletary. Oh, nice pass that time. Penetration, shot put up from the corner, up and in. That's a 3 for Kalen Harkema. He's got 7 points in the ballgame. 3-pointer on the way by DeLon Dean. Won't go. And let's see here. Jacoria Harris underneath. Got tangled up in there, kind of favoring that left leg just a little bit. And the personal foul is going to be on McKee. Ezra McKee called for his 2nd personal foul. That's actually his 3rd personal foul on McKee. And heading to the free throw line will be Jacoria Harris. Harris, 4 points in that first half. He was 0 for 3 at the free throw line in that first half. Shot is on the way, and it is off the front of the iron. No good. Looks like Luke Bright is going to come in. Terry Anderson checks out. So it's Bright, Collins, Harris, Dean, and Nash in the lineup for the Colts. 2nd shot, up and in there. There you go, Jacoria. He's got 5 points. And the Colts lead it 74-32. Larrion Ford. They'll work it left side to Osby. Nice spin move inside, but there's Cortez Collins setting up the roadblock. Pass inside. They get it to Ford. And the shot is put up and in. Larrion Ford with the basket. And the Colts 74-34 right now. Malik Nash on the attack. He'll back it back out again. They'll work it right side to Dean. Cross courts it to Bright. Bright gets it back out to Nash. Out to Dean. He'll step back for the 3. Oh,
When you're feeling it, you're feeling it, huh? When you're hot, you're hot, in the words of Jerry Reed. He's got 25 points in the ball game, including 7 3-pointers. DeLon Dean on the night. 77-34, Colts on top by a bunch with 11:05 to go. Three-pointer on the way by McKee, won't go. There's Malik Nash, offside rebound, comes the other way with it. Kicks it in the corner. Three-pointer on the way by DeLon Dean. He's just money tonight, all night long. DeLon Dean, 28 points in the ball game, 8 3-pointers. And he's not done yet, 80-34. Good to see Dean hit that rhythm. That's what the coaching staff had been looking for. They've been telling us all along, the kid can shoot. Now he steals the ball on the other end. They'll bring it the other way. Drives through the lane, kicks it back out to Luke Bryant for three. Off the iron, no good. There's Collins to grab that rebound. And they're going to say, what? Over the back? He's over everybody's back. Have you seen how tall that kid is? Now Cortez is going to be called for the personal foul. Cortez is going to come out of the lineup. They call him Tez. Tez and Malik and Ja'Coria Harris coming out of the lineup. Looks like Jordan Wright, Leighton Jackson, and looks like DeCorian Phillips will check back in. Three-pointer on the way. Or actually, is that a three? It is a three. Put up and in. And that looked to be Ezra McKee. He's got three threes on the night. Bright gets it over to Jordan Wright. Out to the Colts, Leighton Jackson, top of the key. That's Bright. Bright works it left side. DeLon Dean. That one's off the iron, no good. And the rebound's going to come off to the Larrion Ford. Ford's going to get it on to Harkema. Shot over Leighton Jackson will not go in the rebound. Jordan Wright off his kneecap, out of bounds. 80-37, Colts on top with 9:33 to play in the ball game. Beautiful sunshiny day outside. Boy, you can see the windows all the way around this gymnasium. Fantastic facility here at Blinn College. Larrion Ford kicks it out to Harkema. Tries to attack, kicks it into the hands of Jalen Singletary. Puts up the one-hander. He's got it up and in. And the Colts lead it 80-39. Three-pointer on the way by DeLon Dean. Couldn't get it to go. And McKee grabs that rebound. Ezra goes hard to the basket, spins it around. It will not go down. And the personal foul is going to be called on DeCorian Phillips. A Phillips call for the personal. I think that's his first. It is his first. And head to the free throw line will be Ezra McKee. McKee with 9 points in the ballgame, came in averaging 13.5. All of his points have been from the three-point stripe. This one's up and in. He's got 10. Makes it 80-40. Second shot on the way and good. McKee with 11. Colts will face some pressure in the backcourt. They get it ahead to DeLon Dean. Saves it inbounds in the corner. Gets it over to Leighton Jackson to Luke Bright. Bright back to Jackson. Jackson's going to attack, goes strong to the basket. Couldn't get the shot to go. Rebound picked up by Jordan Wright. Rattles it around. It would not go, and the rebound comes off to McKee. Ezra, middle of the court, works it right side to Larrion Ford. Ford has his pass stolen away by Jordan Wright. Wright's going to take it all away. Slam in the middle. Ball goes in, but it's a charging foul on Jordan Wright. He was not going to be denied that time, but charging foul is called, and Jordan picks up his first personal foul. 8.5 minutes to play in the ball game. Colts with a comfortable 80-41 lead. And the Pirates will have it. Harkema gets it off to McKee. McKee works around the screen. Let's see. Going to be a moving screen on Osby? Nope, it's going to be on DeLon Dean. Dean banged into that screen a couple of times, the official.
foul on DeLon Dean. And that is his third personal foul of the night. Pirates get it inbound to Larrion Ford. Ford, free throw line, puts it up. Off the iron, no good. The rebound picked up by Osby. Fall away, no good. And the rebound comes off to Jordan Wright. Wright's going to work it ahead to DeCorian Phillips. Phillips over to Bright. As Luke shot a little bit short, rebound underneath by Jordan Wright. Turnaround shot put up and in. Wright gets the basket. That's his first two of the night. Colts on top, 82-41. Right side, McKee. Goes left side. In the hands of Harkema. Nice drive to the basket as Harkema puts it up and in. Harkema now with 9 points in the game. And the Colts will bring it across the midcourt stripe. 7:15 to play in the ball game. Around the screen, Phillips gets it up to Leighton Jackson. His shot will not go, and the rebound comes off to the Pirates. They'll come the other way. Larrion Ford out on the wing. Drives inside the lane, looking for some help. Gets it to McKee. McKee spin move inside. Collision in there, traveling call. That's Jordan Wright over there defensively. He, along with Luke Bright, creating that turnover. Looks like Leighton Jackson's going to come out right quick. As will Luke. No. Let's see. That's going to be DeLon Dean's coming out. So it's you're going to have Bright along with Jacoria Harris, Shane Bell, Jordan Wright, and DeCorian Phillips in the lineup. Pass underneath. Jacoria Harris going strong in the basket. Couldn't get it to go. Jordan Wright's shot would not go. Pirates have it. Trailing 82-43. 6.5 minutes to play in the contest. Collision out front. A blocking foul going to be called on Shane Bell. 82-43. And it looks like Cortez Collins is going to come in, and Jordan Wright's going to come out. Shane Bell called for his second personal foul of the day. Seventh team foul against the Colts. That free throw on the way. Snagging that rebound's Jalen Singletary. Turn around, put it right back up and in. Singletary with 6 points on the night. And the Colts lead is 82-45. Shane Bell out to Corian Phillips, gets it off to Cortez Collins. Collins going to the free throw line. Cortez fouled in the act of shooting. Cortez is a good free throw shooter, too. Brian McKnight called for the personal foul. His first free throw line is Cortez Collins. Collins in the scoring column for the first time tonight. It's Terry Anderson, along with Cameron Woods. Coming in, looks like Luke Bright and Jacoria Harris coming out. Malik Nash, that is, getting set to check in. Must be going in for Cortez Collins here in just a moment. It's Collins. Knocks down that first free throw. He's got a second one coming here. Second shot on the way. In and out, no good. And the rebound comes off to the Pirates. Into the front court, that's Kentavis Turner, shot put up and in. Colts lead it 83-47. Under 6 minutes to go in the ball game. Shane Bell with a basketball. Out to DeCorian Phillips. Free throw line, that's Collins. Back over to Bell for three. That one will not go, and the rebound's going to be picked up by the Pirates. Brian McKnight with it. He'll bring it the other way. McKnight up top. Kentavis Turner, that is. At the free throw line, drives through the lane, scoops it up and in. Turner gets the basket. He's got 4 points in the game. And the Colts lead it 83-49 with 5:15 to play in the game. We got a timeout on the court. Our score, Colts 83, Victoria 49. I'm guessing this is not working, right, John? Do we want to even touch it?
I don't think so either.
Well, I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? Colts lead it 83-49. And the perimeter shooting, as we said, been a big, big difference for the Colts tonight. They've got DeLon Dean's got 8 3-pointers in this ball game. I think they had, 11 3-pointers at the half. They've added 4 more here in the second half. So 15 3-pointers on the day. Let me check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I'm counting 15. There we go. 15 3-pointers on the day. As the Colts have it, as we resume action here, Shane Bell goes baseline, lays it high off the glass, can't get it to go. Osby grabs the rebound. Actually, that's Singletary. Gets it to McKee. Out front to McKnight. Right side. Down low. Ball in traffic. Whistle and a foul. Going to be a reaching foul on somebody here. And I think they're going to call that on Malik Nash. So Nash should call for the personal foul. That's only his second. And heading to the free throw line. Thought they called it on Nash. That may have been on Shane Bell instead. If that's the case, that's his third. At the free throw line, that is Turner. Turner knocks it down. He's got 5 points in the ball game. He'll have another one coming. Second shot on the way, and it's good. Colts on top, 83-51. They've led by more than 40 on a couple of occasions here. Inside the lane, Cameron Woods, fall away, tips it back out to Bell. Shane Bell back up top to Cameron Woods. He'll take the three, in and out, no good. There's Terry Anderson to tip it up and in. Anderson now with 17 points in the ball game. Colts bringing it the other way. That's Anderson going in for the stuff. Whistling a foul. That'll be on McKee. McKee wasn't going to give up the easy basket. Anderson will head to the free throw line. He's got 17 points in the ballgame. 1 out of 2 at the free throw line tonight. Shot on the way. It's good. Anderson now with 18 points. Second only to DeLon Dean, who has 27. Actually 28 for DeLon Dean. There we go. Anderson will have another one coming here. 86-51 our score with 4:20 to go in the ballgame. Second shot will not go. And the rebound is pulled down by Singletary. That's McKee. Pass tipped away, picked up by DeCorian Phillips. Lost the handle on it momentarily. DeLon Dean will take the three. Can't get it to go. And the rebound is hauled down by Noah Latin. Latin to McKee. Ezra works it left side. Pass tipped away by the Colts. Coming the other way with it. That's DeCorian Phillips. Phillips backs it out beyond the arc. Fronted by McKee. Out to Malik Nash. Right side. Going baseline. Shot put up and in by Cameron Woods. Nice move on the basket by Woods. He's in double figures. He had 5 in the first half, 5 in the second half. Colts on top, 88-51. 3:25 to go in the ball game. Pirates with it. They'll cross court it. Out to Harkema for 3. It's up and in. Hasn't been easy going for Harkema and team tonight, but with that 3, he's got 12 points in the ball game. Driving through the lane, laying it up and in. Malik Nash. Nice burst of speed there to get by everybody. Lay it up and in. He's got 6 points, and the ball goes out of bounds off the foot of the Colts. 90-54. Division II UA Cossetot on top by 36 over Division I Victoria. 2:58 remaining in this game. Harkema has it, working against Terry Anderson. He'll lob it down low. Osby, nice turnaround one-hander by the 6'10 freshman. Colts with it now. They'll work it down low. And taking it baseline. That's DeLon Dean. Loose ball picked up by Terry Anderson. Goes inside. Gets it in the corner to Nash.
Malik will get it out to Anderson. 11 seconds on the shot clock. Anderson gets it out to DeCorian Phillips. He'll step back, take the three, won't get it to go this time. And Harkema grabs the rebound with 2:16 to go in the game. Colts on top, 90-56. Shot from the perimeter, no good. The rebound, there's a whistle down low. That may be on Cameron Woods from the backside. Let's see. Nope, that is actually going to be on Malik Nash. Nash called for the personal foul. That'll be his third. Actually, that's his second personal foul. Heading to the free throw line will be Osby, Johnny Osby. Shot rattles around, goes in. Johnny on the day, now in double figures with 10. He'll have another one coming here, 90-57. 2:09 to go in this one. Second shot's on the way, good. Colts have it, leading 90-58 with 2 minutes to go in this game. Left side, that's Anderson. A little shake and bake on the perimeter. Goes baseline, kicks it in the corner. They'll work it rapidly around into the hands of Cameron Woods. Back out to Malik Nash, draws the pressure, loose ball on the court. Nash in traffic hits the court. Coming the other way, and it's gonna be a call on Terry Anderson. Anderson called, and heading to the free throw line will be Ezra McKee. Anderson, is that his second? Third foul on Terry Anderson. McKee goes to the free throw line. Shots on the way and good. He's got 12 points in the ball game. 3 for 3 at the free throw line. Looks like Terry Anderson's coming out. Luke Bright's coming back in. Also in the lineup, looks to be Corey Harris. Second shot by McKee is good. Colts have it in the backcourt. Malik Nash. Nash working against Harkema. That's Luke Bright. Thought about the three. They'll get it to Harris. Harris over to Malik Nash. Nash lost it off his foot for a moment. Now he's down on the court. Coming the other way. That's Harkema going. And laying it up and in is Harkema. Colts 90, Victoria 62. Closing moments of this one right here. Right side, Bright. Pass inside, goes to Cameron Woods. Bright tries to save it in bounds, can't quite. The ball goes out of bounds. Turnover going over to Victoria. The Colts have come away with another win. Leading 90-62 with a minute to play in this game. Three-pointer on the way, in and out, no good. Rebound's gonna be pulled down by Cameron Woods. Woods gets it ahead to Nash, over to Bright. Bright, they'll whoop it back up top to Cameron Woods, to Nash underneath, as Ja'Coria Harris, looked like they were over there, his back right there, but anyway, to no avail, 90-62. Not gonna make a difference here. Pass inside, Osby going to the basket, going to be fouled by Luke Bright. So Luke Bright called for the personal foul. Looked like Osby gave him an extra little nudge with his shoulder there after the play was over with. Bright right there as it gets the rebound, has it tipped out by the Pirates. Colts will have it on the far end. Inbounds pass. Cameron Woods goes to Dean. Tossing it around the perimeter here. 22 seconds to go in the game. There's a 2 second differential on the shot clock here, so Colts will have to put up a shot if they choose to do so. Dean backs it out, down to 9 seconds on the shot clock. Dean goes inside the lane, lays it up, can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to Osby. They'll get it ahead to Harkema. He's going to pull up for the three, and he nails it at the buzzer. So the Colts win it by a final margin of 90-67, a game that really wasn't that close. As we take a look, we'll keep it right here. It looks like 28 points in the ball game tonight for DeLon Dean. Dean had 8 three-pointers on the night. So 24 of his 28 points were from beyond the arc. 18 points tonight for Terry Anderson. Anderson returning the lineup after missing the game last night because of a flagrant foul earlier in the week. Looks like 10 points on the night for DeCorian Phillips, 10 points for Shane Bell, 10 points for Cameron Woods. Very popular score. Also on the night, looks like Malik Nash finished with 6. 2 points tonight for Jordan Wright, and 1 point this evening for Cortez Collins. Again, your final score tonight is the Colts 58, Victoria College 20. Next time out for the Colts and the Lady Colts will be Thursday evening, as we'll be back at the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gymnasium, as we'll be taking on Southern University Shreveport on Thursday night. 5 o'clock for the ladies, 7 o'clock for the men. You'll catch all the action right here on NADARadio.com. For John Bunyard, I'm Lauren Hinton. Y'all have a great weekend.